Hello dear students, today we will see how to convert a given polynomial into the factorial polynomial. So here we are dealing with the topic that is factorial polynomial. What is the example here? Express the function fx, x to the power 4 plus 5x cube minus 3x square plus 7x plus 5 in factorial notation. That means we have to convert this polynomial into the factorial polynomial, and as well as it is asked to you, hence find its third order forward difference. So we'll see that later on, ki kaise we'll find out that third order forward difference. And now, first of all, we write down the given f of x as it is. Now we know that this is the fourth degree polynomial we are having. Okay, so what we do here, first of all, we write down the coefficients here of this x to the power 4, x cube, x square and x, and the constant term first of all. So coefficient of x to the power 4, what is it? This is 1, which is written here. Coefficient of x cube, what is it? 5, which is written here. And the coefficient of x square, which is minus 3, it is written here. Coefficient of x, it is 7, and the constant term, it is what? 5. So now we start dividing by the 0, or you can start dividing by this what? 1 as well. So whatever you want. So here I divide by the 0 first of all. So first of all, what we do, this 1 we write down as it is here. After that, I take a multiplication of this 0 with the 1. So 0 into 1, the multiplication is what? 0, which I write here. Then I do the addition of this 2. Addition is what? It is 5. Then again I do the multiplication. 0 into 5. What is it? It is 0, which is written here. Then do the addition. It is what? Minus 3. After that again, I multiply 0 with minus 3, which I write here. This will be 0 here. Then do the addition. 7 plus 0, it is what? 7. And after that again, 0 into 7, I do the multiplication, which I write here, which is 0. Then do the addition, which is 5 here. Okay? I suppose this is clear to you, this line. Now after that, we start dividing by the 1. And if you start dividing with the 1 directly, so that time you have to exclude the 5. That you can do. Otherwise, do it like this. That is, start dividing by 0. So if I take the 1 here, dividing by the 1. So this 1, first of all, I write on here. Now, we do the multiplication 1 into 1, which I write here. This is what? 1. Then do the addition 5 plus 1, that is 6. After the multiplication 1 into 6, which is 6, it is written here. Do the addition, minus 3 plus 6, it is what? 3. Then multiplication 1 into 3, what is it? 3, which is written here. Then addition of 7 plus 3 is what? 10. After that again we exclude the last digit, that is what? 10. So first of all we have here exclude the 5, then we exclude, it is what? 10. Now dividing by the 2 now. What we do again? This 1 I write up as it is. Then 2 into 1, that is 2. Then addition of this 2, 6 plus 2, it is what? 8. Then 2 into 8, what is it? 16. Again do the addition, 3 plus 16 is what? 19. Exclude this 19. Now dividing by 3. Again the same thing we will do. 1 I write down here. 3 into 1, what is it? It is 3, which is written here. 8 plus 3, what is it? 11, which is written here. After that exclude this 11. Now dividing by the 4. This 1 I write down the as it is. Now after getting these numbers, which is written here to the right corner, this lowest one denote the coefficient of x to the power 4 factorial. This in bracket denote the factorial notation. It is x to the power 4 factorial. Then this 11 denote the coefficient of x to the power 3 factorial. This 19 denote the coefficient of x to the power 2 factorial. You have to go in the reverse order. Then this 10 denote the coefficient of x to the power 1 factorial. And this 5 denotes the coefficient of x to the power 0 factorial, which is nothing but 1. Okay, so here we just write down the factorial polynomial. How to write down the factorial polynomial? We just write down the fx here, which is equals to, I just told you, this 1 is the coefficient of x to the power 4 factorial. So I write down 1 into that, x to the power 4 factorial. Plus, then coefficient of x to the power 3 factorial is what? 11. So we know it is what? 11 into x to the power 3 factorial. Then we write down 19 into x to the power 2 factorial, then 10 into x to the power 1 factorial, and then it is 5 into x to the power 0 factorial, which is written here. And you know that x to the power 0 factorial is what? 1, which is constant term, and as well as x to the power 1 factorial is what? X. Okay, you just remember this definition, that is of factorial polynomial. That is, if I write down the x to the power 1 factorial, that is nothing but 1, it is x. X to the power 2 factorial means, what is it by definition? X into x minus 1. X to the power 3 factorial, this we write down as x, x minus 1 and x minus 2. Likewise it goes so on. Okay, and I have told you already x to the power 0 factorial is what? 1. So here we have expressed the given function as a factorial polynomial of degree is what? 4. Already we are having this polynomial of degree 4. This is a normal polynomial. Now after that is asked to you, find out the third order forward difference. Okay, so third order difference we have to find out. So what we do here, we just apply the delta operator. This is the forward difference operator. And how we operate this one, you just have to remember this formula. If I apply this delta over the factorial notation, that is to the x to the power n, this act like the differential operator. How you do then? It is n x to the power n minus 1 factorial. It act like the derivative operator, that you know already know the derivative operator d by dx x to the power n. If I am having this one, this will be written as n x to the power n minus 1. So on the same line, this delta operator act on the factorial polynomial. So we just take the first forward difference, that is delta of fx, and that is equals to, it is what? 4 I have written here, into x to the power 3 factorial. Then plus 3 I multiplied here with the 11, it is 33 x to the power 2 factorial. Then 2 multiplied here, it is 38 x to the power 1 factorial. 1 multiplied here, it is 10 x to the power 0 factorial, plus x to the power 0 factorial is what? 1. So it is forward difference for this x to the power 0 factorial, that will be, it is 0. Okay, likewise as we find out the derivative of the constant term, it is 0. Therefore the forward difference for the constant term, it is what? 0 here. This is the first forward difference we have calculated. Now we find out the second forward difference. So we just write down the delta square here. Again apply the same formula, 3 into 4, that will be 12 x to the power 2 factorial. Then 2 into 33, that is 66 x to the power 1 factorial. This 1 into 38 x to the power 0 factorial. Okay, then this 10 will be a constant. So forward difference for the 10 will be, is what? 0, because x to the power 0 factorial is what? 1. After that we find out the third forward difference, because it is asked to find out the third forward difference. Now which will be equal to then 2 into 12, 24 x to the power 1 factorial. 1 into 66 x to the power 0 factorial, this is 0 then. So we have got the answer here for the third forward difference. And now we simplify the quantity. We know that the x to the power 1 factorial, what is it? It is what? X. So we have written here, it is x here, and x to the power 0 factorial is what? 1. So here we have got the third forward difference for the given polynomial. Now if you find out this by the actual definition, this third forward difference for this function fx, so it will be a very lengthy process, because we know that the by difference operator, delta of fx, that will be written as f of x plus h minus f of x. So this formula we have to apply then whenever you find out the forward difference. But it is easy to find out the third forward difference by using the factorial notation. And sometimes it will be asked to you find out the third forward difference value at some particular point. Okay, means the value of x will be given to you, and they will ask you find out the third forward difference at some particular point of x. That may be x equals to 3, x equals to 2, likewise. So you just put the value of x, you will get the third forward difference at that particular point. Likewise it goes. So I suppose it is clear to you how to convert the given polynomial of any degree into a factorial polynomial. So this is the one example I have given to you. One more example now we are going to take.